figure, find the resultant force at the center. So here we have to calculate the resultant force at the center. So what is the given figure? It is a square with the side 0.1 meter, charges here plus, this is minus, this is minus, this is plus. So two like charges, two positive charges, two negative charges. Now first let us take a general equation. Center one also 10 microcoulomb. So if I imagine a square, this is plus q, this is plus q, this is minus q, this is minus q, d is the side. So let us take the center point. Here also plus q is placed. Now we are interested, what is the net force? See, if I take this plus q, this repels this plus q, say along with the force F. This minus q attracts this plus q along with direction F. Because we are interested in experiencing force, this plus q experiences force due to this plus q along this direction. At the same time, this negative attracts this positive along this direction. So definitely values are same because distance same, charges same. In the similar way, this plus q repels this plus q along this direction, say F. This minus q attracts this plus q along this direction. That means on the charge at the center, 2F force is acting along this side and another 2F along this side. Because it is a square, the angle between these two is 90 degrees. Therefore, if I take resultant as F dash, which is equal to 2F square plus 2F square, nothing but 2√2F, the resultant force at the center. The direction of this resultant force, because these two are equal, the resultant will be like this. It bisects the angle 45 degrees, so it will be like this. This is our F dash towards right. Now let us calculate what is F. Here from the figure, F is the force between one corner and the center. Now this is D, this is D, so diagonal is root 2D. But we are not interested in diagonal, we are interested half of the diagonal. The value of this half of the diagonal, it is nothing but d root 2d by 2, so it is d by root 2. The distance of one corner from the center of the square is d by root 2, if d is the side. So if I write the equation F, now F becomes equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught times q into q divided by d by root 2 whole square. So this is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught times 2 q square by d square. So substitution this into this equation, our F dash now becomes equal to 2√2F. F is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into 2 q square by d square. So if I separate the terms, this is 4√2 times 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q square by d square. Substitute the values. 4√2, this is 9 into 10 to the power of 9. Charge is 10 microcoulomb and side is 1. So 10 into 10 to the power of minus 6 whole square by distance 1 by 10 whole square. So this is 9 into 4, 36√2 times, this is 10 to the power of 9, this is 10 power 5 minus 5 whole square, 10 to the power of minus 10 into this is 10 square. So 10 power 9 into 10 square is 10 power 11. So remaining 360 root 2 newtons towards right. The center one will experience a force 360 root 2 towards right. The resultant force acting at the center. So four charges are placed, one side plus, the other side minus. Center charge is also some plus, resultant at the center. Suppose if I take all are like charges, what is the resultant force at the center? Whether it is plus or minus, whatever you take. So automatically resultant at the center becomes 0 if all are like charges. Suppose if I take opposite corners like charges, this is minus q, this is minus q, then what is the force at the center? Again the value 0. So depending on the charge distribution, maybe four charges, the resultant may be 0 or finite.